This juice contains a variety of enzymes like disaccharides, example, maltase, dipeptidases, lipases, nucleosidases, etc. The mucus along with the bicarbonates from the pancreas protects the intestinal mucosa from acid as well as provide an alkaline medium pH 7.8 for enzymatic activities. Submucosal glands, Brunner's glands also help in this. Proteins, proteases and peptones partially hydrolyzed proteins in the chyme reaching the intestine are acted upon by the proteolytic enzymes of pancreatic juice as given below. Peptones, proteases are converted into dipeptides in the presence of trypsin, chymotrypsin and carboxypeptidase. Carbohydrates in the chyme are hydrolyzed by pancreatic amylase into disaccharides. Polysaccharides are converted into disaccharides in the presence of amylase. Fats are broken down by lipases with the help of bile into di- and monoglycerides. Fats are converted into diglycerides in the presence of lipases and then converted into monoglycerides. Nucleases in the presence in the pancreatic juice acts on nucleic acids to form nucleotides and nucleosides. Nucleic acids are converted into nucleotides in the presence of nucleases and then converted into nucleosides. The enzymes in the sulcus entericus act on the end products of the above reactions to form the respective simple absorbable forms. These final steps in digestion occur very close to the mucosal epithelial cells of the intestine. Dipeptides are converted into amino acids in the presence of dipeptidases. Maltose is converted into glucose plus glucose in the presence of maltase. Lactose is converted into glucose plus galactose in the presence of lactase. Sucrose is converted into glucose plus fructose in the presence of sucrase. Nucleotides are converted into nucleosides in the presence of nucleotidases and converted into sugars plus bases in the presence of nucleosidases. Di- and monoglycerides are converted into fatty acids plus glycerol in the presence of lipases. The breakdown of biomacromolecules mentioned above occurs in the duodenum region of the small intestine. The simple substances thus formed are absorbed in the jejunum and ileum regions of the small intestine. The undigested and unabsorbed substances are passed on to the large intestine. No significant digestive activity occurs in the large intestine. The function of large intestine are 1. Absorption of some water, minerals and certain drugs. 2. Secretion of mucus which helps in adhering the waste undigested particles together and lubricating it for an easy passage. The undigested and absorbed substances called feces enters into the cecum of the large intestine through ileocecal valve which prevents the backflow of the fecal matter. It is temporarily stored in the rectum till defecation. The activities of the gastrointestinal tract are under neural and hormonal control for proper coordination of different parts. The sight, smell and the presence of food in the oral cavity can stimulate the secretion of saliva. Gastric and intestinal secretions are also similarly stimulated by neural signals. The muscular activities of different parts of the alimentary canal can also be moderated by neural mechanisms both local and through CNS. Hormonal control of the secretion of digestive juices is carried out by local hormones produced by gastric and intestinal mucosa. Calorific value of protein, carbohydrates and fats. The energy requirements of animals and the energy content of food are expressed in terms of measure of heat energy because heat is the ultimate form of all energies. This is often measured to as calories A-L or joule J, which is the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree centigrade. Since this value is tiny amount of energy, physiologists commonly use kilocalorie kcal or kilojoule kj. 1 kilocalorie is the amount of energy required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree centigrade. Nutritionists traditionally refer to kcal as the calorie or joule, always capitalized. The amount of heat liberated from a complete combustion of 1 gram food in a bomb calorimeter, a closed metal chamber filled with O2, is its gross calorific or gross energy value. The actual amount of energy combustion of 1 gram of food is the physiologic value of food. Gross calorific values of carbohydrates, proteins and fats are 4.1 kilocalorie per gram, 5.65 kilocalorie per gram and 9.45 kilocalorie per gram respectively, whereas their physiologic values are 4.0 kilocalorie per gram, 4.0 kilocalorie per gram and 9.0 kilocalorie per gram respectively. Absorption of digestive products. Absorption is the process by which the end products of digestion pass through the intestinal mucosa into the blood or lymph. It is carried out by passive, active or facilitated transport mechanisms. Small amounts of monosaccharides like glucose, amino acids and some electrolytes like chloride ions are generally absorbed by simple diffusion. The passage of these substances into the blood depends upon the concentration gradients. However, some substances like glucose and amino acids are absorbed with the help of carrier proteins. This mechanism is called the facilitated transport. Transport of water depends upon the osmotic gradient. Active transport occurs against the concentration gradient and hence requires energy. Various nutrients like amino acids, monosaccharides like glucose, electrolytes like NaPlus are absorbed into the blood by this mechanism. Fatty acids and glycerol, being insoluble, cannot be absorbed into the blood. They are first incorporated into small droplets called micelles, which move into the intestinal mucosa. They are reformed into very small protein-coated fat globules called the chylomicrons, which are transported into the lymph vessels, lacteals in the villi. These lymph vessels ultimately release the absorbed substances into the bloodstream. Absorption of substances takes place in different parts of the alimentary canal like stomach, mouth, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. However, maximum absorption occurs in the small intestine. The summary of absorption, sites of absorption and substances absorbed. Summary of absorption in different parts of digestive system. Mouth. Certain drugs coming in contact with the mucosa of mouth and lower side of the tongue are absorbed into the blood capillaries lining them. Stomach. Absorption of water, simple sugars and alcohol etc. takes place. Small intestine. Principal organ for absorption of nutrients. The digestion is completed here and the final products of digestion such as glucose, fructose, fatty acids, glycerol and amino acids are absorbed through the mucosa into the bloodstream and lymph. Large intestine. Absorption of water, some minerals and drugs takes place. The absorbed substances finally reach the tissues which utilize them for their activities. This process is called assimilation. The digestive waste solidified into coherent feces in the rectum initiate a neural reflex causing an urge or desire for its removal. The ejection of feces to the outside through the anal opening defecation is a voluntary process and is carried out by a mass peristaltic movement. Disorders of digestive system. The inflammation of the intestinal tract in the most common ailment due to bacterial or viral infections. The infections are also caused by the parasites of the intestine like tapeworm, roundworm, threadworm, hookworm and pinworm etc. Jaundice. The liver is affected, skin and eyes turn yellow due to the deposit of bile pigments. Vomiting. It is the ejection of stomach contents through the mouth. This reflex action is controlled by the vomit center in the medulla. A feeling of nausea precedes vomiting. Diarrhea. The abnormal frequency of bowel movement and increased liquidity of the fecal discharge is known as diarrhea. It reduces the absorption of food. Constipation. In constipation, the feces are retained within the colon as the bowel movements occur irregularly. Indigestion. In this condition, the food is not properly digested, leading to a feeling of fullness. The causes of indigestion are inadequate enzyme secretion, anxiety, food poisoning, overeating, and spicy food. PEM. Dietary deficiencies of proteins and total food calories are widespread in many underdeveloped countries of South and Southeast Asia, South America, and West and Central Africa. Protein energy malnutrition, PEM, may affect large sections of the population during drought, famine, and political turmoil. This happened in Bangladesh during the liberation war and in Ethiopia during the severe drought in mid-80s. PEM affects infants and children to produce marasmus and kwashior kok. Marasmus is produced by a simultaneous deficiency of proteins and calories. It is found in infants less than a year in age. If mother's milk is replaced too early by other foods which are poor in both proteins and caloric values, this often happens if the mother has second pregnancy or childbirth when the older infant is still too young. In marasmus, protein deficiency impacts growth and replacement of tissue proteins, extreme emaciation of the body, and thinning of limbs results. The skin becomes dry, thin, and wrinkled. Growth rate and body weight decline considerably. Even growth and development of brain and mental faculties are impaired. Kwashior kok is produced by protein deficiency unaccompanied by calorie deficiency. It results from the replacement of mother's milk by a high-calorie, low-protein diet in a child more than 1 year in age. Like marasmus, kwashior kok shows wasting of muscles, thinning of limbs, failure of growth, and brain development. But unlike marasmus, some fat is still left under the skin. Moreover, extensive edema and swelling of body parts are seen.